I did not prepare a speech for tonight, but he said good. But of course, I have to thank you so much for those wonderful remarks, Courtney, and of course, Mark. It has been a phenomenal experience, and of course, the students and the families. And of course, I need to thank my wife and children who are up there in the middle. The way I look at it is that you have all given me this chance to do all these things, and I have told, and Mr. Corey is the new music department chairman, so let's give him a congratulations. But I've been telling people that whatever people might give me credit for, he deserves credit for it too, because we've been bouncing ideas off each other all this whole time, and it's been a fabulous experience. The students have just been so amazing. I've learned so much from you over the years, so thank you so much. All right, there's more, apparently.
So you can have a seat. No. So this year's been several surprises. First of all, Legacy was a surprise when we premiered it. This sort of soft premiere, as it were, with the Chicagoland Educators Orchestra back in the end of November. What Mr. O'Connell doesn't know is that several of his alumni, maybe we can start, hit their red button. We're good, yes, probably. Close enough for jazz, I'll just, 100%. So what Mr. O'Connell doesn't know is that part of this process also included reaching out to some alumni. I want to thank personally the Scolas for meeting with me, Jackie and Joe, and helping set up this a Facebook secret group on Facebook. So there has been a secret group on Facebook that is may not speak English. So. Just pushing his hands down, thank you. And what we asked alumni to do is to leave a little message. Before that, I would like, there are a lot of alumni here already tonight. So they knew about this concert event. So alumni and parents of alumni and parents that have come back, would you all please stand so we can see you? But your alumni have been leaving you messages on this Facebook group, and this is a small sampling of the more than 1 hour's worth of videos that were uploaded to this Facebook group that you'll become a member of later this night. It'll no longer be secret, and you'll be able to see all the videos. But ladies and gentlemen, we'd like to show you now a few messages from over the years from Mr. O'Connell's alumni. So Mr. Hollett, if you wouldn't please, thank you.
Perpetual motion, the Irish washerwoman. I remember having I really enjoyed my time playing in the orchestra, and I'm sure part of that is because I liked music, but I'm sure a huge part of that was because of you.
I was a little working class brown grunge kid. Prior to Mr. Corey's time, and had been teaching myself electric bass since junior high. And by sophomore year in high school, I wanted to learn more formally. I wanted to learn contrabass, and I wanted to join orchestra. And that's when I met you. Now, I hadn't been learning since fourth grade, like a lot of the other students, but you had no qualms with that. In fact, you were so excited to teach me.
I want to thank you for everything you did all these years for the kids. You've been a positive influence on them since they were in fourth grade. You gave them the confidence to get up on stage and perform. You didn't put limitations on them. You pushed them to reach their goals and get out of their comfort zone, which has translated into their personal and professional lives today.
I just want to let you know that I am who I am because of you. I have the life that I have because of you. I have you to thank for so much. I'll keep it short here and just say that I owe you for walking into my classroom in 1989 at Lake Park Elementary School and introducing me to the violin. I now play the violin and teach strings and orchestra as my career. You gave me my confidence, you gave me my career. I met my husband through his career, so I feel like you're kind of responsible for my family as well, our three children. I can't even begin to think who I would be, where I would be, and what I would be doing if you had not been such a positive role model in my life. Just want to say thanks so much. Any teacher definitely leaves such a huge effect on students. However, music educators definitely leave such a lasting impression on their students because they're with them for 4+ years. So I just want to thanks for all you've done, and I want to quick apologize for the lack of intonation. Sorry, I didn't figure that out quite until college.
I'm going to take you back to about 93, 94, Pop's concert. It was a very simple arrangement. You knew that I was teaching myself how to play drums, my personal time. There was a percussion part in the arrangement, and you asked me if I wanted to play. Of course, I said yes. You knew I could handle it. About 3/4 of the way through this song, there was a four measure drum solo. So I asked you what you wanted to do, and you said, play whatever you want. We didn't have a drum set set up, so you, no one else in the orchestra, nobody knew what I was going to do, and I never had a chance to practice that in front of everybody. So we got to the day of the show. So we get through the song, we get to the drum solo, and I led this with my best four measures of John Bonham that I could come up with. And I just remember looking over at those percussionists and half of our orchestra sitting there with their jaws open. The point of the story is not that I absolutely slayed those four measures. It's the fact that you let me do it. With you, there were no limitations and there were no expectations when it came to music. And that's a mindset that I've kept with me in my music today and in my personal life.
You taught us so many life lessons. You had an endless amount of patience for us and always tried making learning fun. You had a great way of challenging us individually based on our skills. You always had a smile on your face and a joke in your back pocket.
When you told me you were retiring, I realized that my daughter would be entering high school the year after you retired. She wouldn't get the opportunity to have you as a conductor, and that made me sad. Every time I've seen you since, you said not to be sad, to be happy for you. So I'm happy for you in your retirement and your next path of life.
He said something to me back in fourth grade that I still think of today. He said, without focus, you will be a jack of all trades and master of none. I still think about that today when I feel like I'm spreading myself too thin. I'm sure I wasn't your easiest student over the years, but you never gave up on me. You even gave me a cello solo for our last concert of senior year. I still can't believe you trusted me with that, but it was probably the pinnacle of my music career.
When I think about my time in orchestra with you, I remember it being one of the better parts of my school day. Most of us did not go out to play in symphonies or begin a career in music, yet because of you, many of us stuck with orchestra for 9 years. That's a testament to being a great teacher.
A few years maybe after you handed me a regular violin, you put an electric violin in my hands, which was like mind-blowing, and certainly came back to serve very well as I played all the way through college. And I was lucky enough to play in a rock band. And I remember one of the first rehearsals that I rolled up to with a huge half stack of amps, you know, bigger than all those Duke guitar players. And I rolled up and was able to show them that playing the violin was pretty cool.
Some of my memories from high school were when you would tell a joke and you would look around the room, most likely getting a bunch of high schoolers' eye rolls in response.
When I was a fourth grader at Gaston School, I was just learning violin for the first time, and he was teaching us proper form and posture. And when it got to the part about how to hold the violin in one hand, he would explain that the bottom of the neck of the violin can get dangerously hot, and we should never touch it with our palm, or else we'd risk burning our hand or something. Now, I don't know why fourth grade me thought this fact was plausible, but I was going home and assumed that he was telling the truth. And it took me a longer time than I'm proud to admit to figure out that he was just joking.
Thought I'd try to string together a classical set of music puns. The whole note just sort of fell flat. I'll just waltz through the rest of this and on a more serious note. And that's how you win among the best. And it's a bummer to see you go. It was really great to be part of one of your very first classes and have you follow us most of the love that way. Just seeing all the students sharing their stories since then, it's obviously that you built something great there, so.
I heard you're retiring. That is amazing. That is also slightly depressing because that means it's been 20 years since I walked those halls, but not really because this is a happy occasion. People ask me in my daily life regularly, Steve, how the heck are you so happy? You're always smiling, you're always goofy, you're always just so, you know, how are you so like that? And every now and then I'll let them in on a secret and I'll tell them that, you know what? When I was a student, there was this guy. He was my orchestra director. His name was Mr. O. And this guy, no matter what day of the week, no matter what was going on in his life, when I went into school, he was smiling. He was happy to see us. And he always had a joke. And he just so pleasant to be around, and you wanted to do well for him. And I gotta tell you, that more than anything, more than any scale or arpeggio or anything you ever taught me, that just who you are is what actually had the biggest impact on my life, because yeah, it's been 20 years, and in that 20 years there's been a lot of ups and a lot of downs, and what hasn't changed is the outlook on life that I kind of got from you. I wake up every day with a smile on my face, and I greet the day with a positive outlook and just an undying optimism that I'm very grateful to have, because I know that's a rare thing.
You are so enthusiastic and patient and encouraging about music, and it's totally infectious. Now, I was already passionate about music before I came to you. I mean, I did survive three traumatic years of junior high band intro. But you nurtured that passion with a love and respect that I didn't get a lot of before high school. You care about your students so deeply, and it shows. I mean, you care about me. Orchestra Under Your Guidance was dynamic, it was affirming, and it was so much fun. So thank you, Mr. O, for being one of the most important people in so many lives.
You know, you had me up and running within a matter of weeks, and it was just an amazing time. And I, you know, as a teacher, I think about those days, and I think about what you would do every day. You know, there's something comes up, and I'm like, okay, what would Mr. O do in this instance? So
it's just so evident that you have, you know, impacted positively all these people's lives. It's really amazing to see all the support and feedback you are getting.
And during our time together, we got into conversation about graduation and going away to school and how your friendships and relationships can kind of be impacted by that transition. And you were kind enough to share some of your own experiences with us, and you also got to talking about how you and your wife had met. And during this conversation, you gave us a great piece of advice, which was don't look for the perfect person, just be the perfect person. This is something going forward that Angela and I have always thought back on when we're going through relationship issues or whatever it was. And it was always thinking about, as long as you were as good as you could be for yourself, the right person would come along. So whenever we're going through those things, we always think, what would Mr. O say? And it's true, we do say that pretty often, even today.
Hi, I'm Mrs. O'Connell, lucky girl who gets to call Dan my husband. I'd like to thank you all for being here tonight. About a year ago, I contacted Jamie Scola, asking her if there was something we could do to surprise Dan in his last year of teaching. Neither of us was really sure what it would be, but I'm thrilled at how all this has turned out. I'm sure Dan is amazed at how many of you have reached out to him. He has told me more than once he would love to see all of his students again. So thank you, Jamie, and thank you all for being here tonight to make Dan feel so special. My most heartfelt thank you is to the Indian Trail Orchestra in 1990. I'm not sure if that orchestra was made up of 8th graders or 6th and 7th graders also, but in the spring of 1990, Mr. O'Connell took me on a grade school tour to all of the elementary schools in Anson. I was teaching 1st, 2nd, and 3rd grade at Lake Park Elementary at the time. All the students at Lake Park were invited into the gym to hear the Indian Trail Orchestra perform. I remember one of the songs he played was the Sesame Street theme song, and during it, some of the orchestra members walked around. Stuffed animals and Cookie Monster, Big Blue Bird, and Does anyone remember doing that? While sitting in the Lake Park gym watching this concert, I wondered, how can I meet this guy? He has a lot of fun with music, a lot of fun with his students, and I'd really like to meet him. Well, I figured I'd use what was most important to me. So when the concert was over, I took my students back to our classroom, and we wrote thank you notes to your orchestra for such a fabulous performance. Each student wrote their own note, letting me know what a great concert it was. I saved those thank you notes until I saw Dan at Lake Park again, and then I personally delivered them to him. With a big smile, I thanked him for his concert, and I asked him to share these notes with his students. I might have slipped my phone up. Since that time, we have shared so many concerts together. Some of yours, some of Dan's, many of our own children's concerts. But the one that started it all for us was the one that happened at Lake Park Elementary in the spring of 1990. If Dan did not share those thank you notes with me then, I thank you now.
I really will always remember playing for you, and it was one of the most rewarding experiences of my high school career. You're a great teacher, and Addison is really going to miss you. And all of us who play for you are going to always remember playing for you fondly. And I wish you all the luck in retirement, and that's it. Have a good one.
Congratulations on your retirement, and I wish you and your family the absolute best.
I hope you have a fantastic retirement. Congratulations.
I wish you all of the best, and thank you so very much for everything that you gave us over the years, and congratulations.
It's easy to say that orchestra has had a huge impact on our life, and I want to say thanks for everything you did for me, and best of luck in your retirement.
Thank you for all the orchestra memories. Congratulations on a wonderful career, and I wish you all the best in your
future. So I want to say thank you for being there all those years, thank you for making orchestra fun, congratulations on your retirement, and I wish you all the best.
And good luck with all of your future endeavors. Yes, and happy mushroom hunting.
I just want to say congratulations on your retirement, and thank you. Thank you from the bottom of my heart for everything that you have done for me, and of course for all of your students throughout your career.
Very grateful to you for all the time we spent together and for everything that you gave me without even saying a word, just by being who you are. Good man, Mr. O. You're a genuine article. I, myself, and all of your students over the last 30-something years, very lucky to have been in your care. Congratulations, sir. It's an honor to be part of this, and all the best. Enjoy your retirement.
Ladies and gentlemen, thank you to Anthony Fanbuck. Ladies and gentlemen, this is Daniel O'Connell. Congratulations. Thank you. Turn, and there's refreshments, and you can all say hi to Mr. O'Connell. Thank you all for coming.